morning students. Today we are going to discuss the remaining part of the story. The horror of the truth. I lived the rest of my life. I will go to my grave clean. So he is telling that is he is going to wait. He is going to die very soon. The age, because he got a daughter and the son. So he is telling the few years he is going to alive in the earth. That life how he want to serve. He have to serve very clean. While he have to go to the grave, he have to go clean. It means he should not want to do any crime till his death. John, Dad, what did Krishan offered you? Gladwin, $100,000. So $1 is 76 rupees for an Indian currency. So they had given $100,000. They had given to offered to Gladwin by Krishan. So what? Eve is very surprised and she is asking what. Martha also replying, Robert. Gladwin, he put it aside for me without anybody knowing it. It's put it his private fortune. He says he is not a it is not the depositor's money, as if it had made any difference. So for his fortune, for present fortune, he has saved the money for his future and he kept aside. It is not the money of the depositor, it is his own income saving. So Eve, he offered you $100,000. See, you have to imagine he is earning only $64 a week. For the whole month he will hear only $240. And imagine $100,000 means, you just imagine how much money he can't able to earn such a big huge amount of money throughout his life also. Gladwin, I could have had it for the one word, yes, that even for nodding my head and looking for the eyes. So only one yet, even he will nod his head, he will shake his head also, he will get the money. How do you have to mean know me? Gladwin, the word is good. Even now he never lied to me. John, I suppose my eyes must have shown something. I didn't felt, I noticed it. He unlocked the drawer and showed the 100,000. So with for a single word, the word is good, the word is good, I won't remember, but for that he is going to give $100,000 he is going to offer. And he had showed the money which is kept in the drawer, opening the unlocked means he has opened the drawer and he had shown the money. John, in cash? He is asking whether it is in the cash. Gladwin, in $1,000 bill, they were genuine. I examined it. So all the cash are not a black money. It is not a printed money. It is a original currency. He had gone through. Eve, and for what he wants you to say? I don't remember. For all the three words he is going to say, I don't remember. For that he is going to offer him such a huge amount, $100,000. So just that three words only, don't you, but you won't, shaking his head. Those three words could choose me. Choose means it's like killing me. If I try to speak them for the another man, perhaps it could be easy. For the other person other than Gladwin, anyone is ready and anyone will agree that they will say, I don't know, I don't remember, and they easily they will get the compliment of the money which is going to rewarded by John Krishan. But for the Gladwin, it is not able, because the word itself make him to kill. He won't say any lies throughout his life. All of my past could rise up and strung me in the face. It could be mean that to the world that for the years I have been living a lie. So throughout his life till today, he was not even said a single word of lie in his whole throughout his lifetime. So now they are asking him to say the lie. That I was not a honorable man, I thought, and I was. When John Krishan offered the money, I was angry, but when I rejected and he showed no surprise, then I was pleased. It was a compliment, don't you think so? So what happened when John Krishan had shown the money, he was not agreed, that makes him no, he had not felt any surprise. John Chrysostom had not felt any surprise because he already know about him very well. If you give money also, he will not ready to accept it. So this is a very great compliment because his friend knows about him very well. John, rather an expensive compliment. It is very expensive, very huge amount. It's very expensive compliment. Bladwin, he is having a pass. And John, a compliment which costs you for $100,000. What is the compliment he is going to give? $100,000 for a single lie, that is, I don't remember. Bladwin, a compliment which was worth of $100,000. I have never had the money, much money to spend in my life. John, but if I had, I could imagine a finer way to spend it. Even he don't want such a money in his life, throughout his life. Even he don't know how, he can't able to imagine how he is going to spend the money. John, yes, I suppose to. John also replying, he don't know how to spend the money because the money is beyond the level of their income. Martha, will the depositor lose much, Robert? She is asking whether this is a money from the depositor, whether the depositor is going to lose any money. Bladwin, the depositors will not lose a cent. Even they are not going to lose. In Indian currency, we will say no, not even a single rupee. Likewise, they are not even going to lose a cent. We were able to save something from the Rick, the Chrysostom and I. It was more than I had accepted, almost twice as much, and with that Chrysostom had, it will be enough. So they are not going to lose anything. This is the thing that he had, twice the money he had saved, and it's enough for the Chrysostom. So he can able to repay the money for the depositors as well as the bank will go smooth. Even without the 100,000, he was asking, without the 100,000, whether he can able to repay all the money. Then John is replied, without the money that the Chrysostom had put away for you, yes, I didn't know there was a 100,000 until today. Chrysostom didn't tell me, he reneged without it. Oh, yeah, and John, and you make both ends meet. Bladwin, quite easily. Mr. Marshall is running the reorganization. Mr. Marshall is a third national bank. He hasn't the least idea that is going to turn out so well. So now what they are asking, without the money, whether he is going to reorganize the function. Then one man, another man, he is Mr. Marshall. He is going to reorganize the bank which was came under the loss. So he, even the Mr. Marshall don't know that it will work out very easily without any trouble. So John and the Eve were tempted by the huge amount of money offered by Chrysostom, then try to justify Chrysostom's act of offering Bladwin a bribe. So they are very tempted, where they got temptation towards getting money. So they, what happened? Let us see. So John, they are going to punish Chrysostom, aren't they? So John is asking his father, tomorrow he is going to get the punishment. Bladwin, I am afraid so. It means not in the general meaning. It's not in that sense. Yes, he's agreeing, really it's going to happen. What for what is the reason why he is going to Bladwin? Misappropriating the fund of the bank, that is there they had stopped the fund. Misappropriating the fund means misusing the fund, misusing the sum of amount of money. John, oh, I know that, but what's crime has been committed? Because it is not considered to be the crime, because the person, the depositors is going to get, or they are not going to lose anything. They are going to get their whole amount, and nothing is going to get collapsed. Only he had used the money in some other way to make money. So only crime is there. What is the crime he was committed? He is asking. That crime, John, that crime is mentioning the misappropriating the fund. That is. But if nobody loses anything by it, so here no one is going to lose anything. It is a crime nevertheless. So it is a worthless crime. It is not at all a crime, John. And they are going to punish him for it. No one is going to lose anything. All is going to function in a systematic way. And what is the reason why he is going to get punishment? Could it be such an awful thing, father, if you let him off? Bladwin, I wish I would, Eve, but I am not a judge. So this is the thing, it's going to happen very bad to him, father, Eve had asked. And Bladwin had replied that he is not a judge to determine anything. So he is telling, I am not a judge. He don't know anything what is the judgment is going to come at the tomorrow. No, but you are the only witness against him. Again, Eve is telling, the only witness against him is a father. So Bladwin, Eve, she is John. She is right governor, she is telling. John is replying, what Eve said is right. Bladwin, you too, John, you are also joined hands with Eve. And he is asking, John, it's going to be the nasty mess if they put John Chrism in the jail with your own son name after him. It's going to be the pleasant for me, John Chrism Bladwin. So already at the beginning of this lesson, play itself, I had explained you, John, his full name is John Chrism Bladwin. So he is telling, he is having the name of his own friend. So whether it won't, it's going to create any bad name for him. So John is arguing. Martha, Robert, I am not sure I understood what you are said before. What did Mr. Chrism want you to do for him? So now Martha is inquiring, what Chrism had asked him to do. So get him off tomorrow. So tomorrow we will see everything. You could do that, Martha. Martha is telling, you can do that. And Bladwin said, yes. And how, what is going to say tomorrow? And Bladwin, by answering, I don't remember when they asked me dangerous question. So the thing which Chrism asked Bladwin to do, only one thing, that when they had asked any critical question to him, dangerous question to him, only thing that Bladwin has to reply, that I don't know, I don't remember. Martha, oh, and you do remember? Yes, nearly everything. Martha is asking, do you remember everything? Bladwin said, yes, I know everything. John, no matter what they asked you, whatever matter they will ask, whether you can able to reply. John had asked his father. Bladwin, I can always refresh my memory. You see, I have notes. So Bladwin had replied, he always used to refresh his memory by seeing the notes he had taken. He is remember everything by seeing the notes which he had taken. But without this note, you can't remember. John is telling, without the note, really the father can't able to remember everything. So Bladwin, what do you mean, John? Bladwin is asking, what do you mean? John, as the matter of the fact, you will have to rely on your notes nearly altogether, won't you? So now John had replied that without the notes which he had, without that going through the notes, he can't able to remember anything. So it is more or less, he can't able to remember. Everything else does some same thing. So everything, everybody in the world, they can't able to remember all the each and every incident is happening in their life. Simply for they remember, they have to refer something. So in the same way, everyone will does the same thing. John, that won't be far from the truth if you say I don't remember. So he is telling, if you say I don't remember, it is not a false thing. It is not far from the truth, means it is not going to become a lie. Really, without the note, you can't able to, because without the notes, his father can't able to remember everything. So I don't remember is not such a big lie, he is telling. Bladwin, I don't see that Mr. Chrism is asking so much of you, Bladwin. So Martha is telling, only he is asking you to say only I don't remember. It is not such a big thing. So Bladwin, Martha, he is telling to her wife, Robert, I am as honestable as you. So Martha is telling, I am also as honest as you. Bladwin, I goes without saying, Martha, it's really Bladwin is telling, he is also ready to agree. Martha is also honest person like Bladwin. So Martha, it doesn't seem right to me send an old friend to jail. Robert, I have been thinking the day John was baptized, when the Mr. Chrism stood sponsor for the him, and who proud we are. So Martha is remembering the day when John was baptized. Baptized means in Christian we have a naming ceremony, and we have that Nyanasthanam we used to say in Tamil. So at that ceremony, that John Chrism was standing as a sponsor. Sponsor means they will have a name of Nyanatandai, Nyanatai. They replace the father and the mother. So he is standing there at the time. He feel very proud. Bladwin feel very proud. And when we came home from the church, you said, do you remember what you had said, Robert? Martha is asking whether Bladwin can remember the word what he said after coming from the church. Bladwin, no, what it was, Bladwin can't able to remember. He said, what is the word he said? Martha, you said, Martha, may your own son always live up to the name which we have given him. Do you remember that? Martha had replied that after returning to the home, that father had said, we have to brought up the child in such a way that he have to hold the name which is given to him. The name which have to bring the pride to the name which is given to him. பேருக்கு மரியாதை கொடுக்குற மாதிரி வாழ்றது. That is the thing he had set up. Bladwin, yes, dimly, he is remembered. Dimly means not darkly, dimly means lightly he is remembering. Oh, the only dimling governor, John is now interpret, and he is telling, only dimly, lightly you can remember. Bladwin, what do you mean, John? What is going to say, John? Martha, it could be sad and very sad if they name the John Chrism, your own son name should come to the grief through you, Robert. So, by Robert Bladwin, his name of his the name of his son, it's named after Chrism, so he is going to get caught. It's all the thing is going to happen, it will create that because he is going to become the evidence for his crime. So why do you call it bride money, father? Eve is telling why we have to call this as a bride money. Sorry, I have left one point. Bladwin, Martha, you are telling me to accept the bride money that John Chrism offered me. So he is asking, Bladwin is asking to Martha whether he want to accept the money which he has to give. And Eve had replied, why we want to consider that as a bride money, father? Bladwin, why indeed? Chrism had prettier name for it. He said that he had underpaid me all these years. You know, I have getting only $60 a week when the crash came. When the bank get collapsed, till that day, he is getting only $60 a week. So, what he, Chrism had given a better name than this. He had said, what is the money he had given is underpaid for him. Throughout his 30 years he had worked for him. For that money, if you calculate that money will goes not more than this, not less than this, $100,000. So, Chrism said that he is going to give the money as he was underpaid for him. So, John, S.S. He said the 100,000 representing a difference between what he paid me and what I had actually been worth to him. So he is telling the money which he is going to pay for him, $100,000, it is the money which he had not given him for the whole year of work he had did for him. Then, no less than true, Robert, you have worked for him very faithfully. So Martha is telling, yes, what Chrism had said is right, because he had given only less pay for him. Till the bank crash, he had got only $60 a week. So it is a very less amount he had paid for him. அதுக்கு பதிலாக அவ்வளோ நாள் பணம் கம்மியாக கொடுத்ததுக்கு இந்த $100 கொடுக்குறதுக்கு ஈக்குவலாக இருக்கும் அப்படின்னு நினைக்கிறாங்க. தி பிளாட்வின், ஹி செட் தட் இஃப் ஹி ஹேட் பேய்ட் மீ வாட் ஹீ ஷுட் ஹாவ் ஐ ஹுட் ஹாவ் புட் பை மோர் தென் $100 பை $1,000 பை நவ். ஸோ இஃப் ஹி ஹேட் பேய்டு ப்ராப்பர்லி டெஃபினெட்லி ஹீ மே ஹாவ் த மனி ஆஃப் $100,000 பை நவ். That's so, isn't that? So John is replying, Adhane, he is telling like that. Bladwin, who knows, I never asked him to raise my salary. When he raised it of its own accord, well, what do you think of it, Eve? And he is telling, Bladwin had never demanded Chrism to increase his salary. Whenever he increased of his own interest, he had increased. And he is asking what Eve is thinking about it. Eve, if you go on the stand tomorrow, he is asking, tomorrow you are going to stand on the stand. So it's tomorrow he is going to the court for the inquiry. Bladwin, yes. Eve, and then put John Chrism in the jail, what will people say? If you put the John Chrism in this jail, what people says about you? Eve is asking to his father. Bladwin, when they will say, I have done my duty, Eve, more than, no more and no less. So simply Bladwin is replying that he had done his duty. He had not did anything more and he had not did anything less. What he is supposed to do that he had did. Will they, the people will think like that? Bladwin, why, what should they say? What is the people are going to say about anything? Eve, I don't think so, of course, but other people might say that you have turned a traitor to your best friend. They are thinking that all the people will think what you did something bad to your friend. That is traitor means we are going against our friend. best friend. Bladwin, you don't mean that Eve, it is not right me, Eve herself. Eve, when they find out that they haven't lost any money, when John Crescent tell them that he will pay back every cent, then they won't want him to go to jail, they will feel sorry for him. So when Crescent had replied, say something to the people that he will repay the money as well as the depositors, they are not going to lose even a single cent. What, the people will not like him to go to the jail. They will feel sorry for making him to go to jail. Yes, I believe that. I hope so. So Bladwin is also agreeing that he is believing that, and he also hoping for the best. John, when they won't feel too kindly disposed towards the man who help put him in jail. So, and don't worry, feel too kindly disposed towards the man who help put him in the jail. So John is telling the man who is helping us, we don't want to put him in the jail. Martha, they will say you went back on the old friend Robert. She is telling, we have to save your, they will say you went back on the old friend Robert. It means the people will say that you did some injustice to your old friend. It means we talk back, it means avangala kaati kudukuradhu, that is everything. John, when you pull out your notes in the court to be sure of sending him to the jail. So when you pull out your notes in the court, when he say take the notes and he set everything sure, definitely he will go to the jail. And Mr. Crescent hasn't done anything really wrong. He was supporting Mr. Crescent that he had done nothing wrong. John, it is technicality. What's that? That's what it is. Nobody loses a cent. Nobody want to see him punished. So the people are going to the depositors are going are not going to lose any cent. Even they don't want him to get punished. Except you, Father. Eve is telling that except the only person who want Crescent to go to jail, that is his father. John, yes, you are willing to jail the man after who you are named your son. So now John had said he is going to send a man who named after his son, this named your son, the name. So the name which is get for his son from the man he is going to send to the jail. Martha, I believe it's being merciful, Robert. Martha is telling whether it is a merciful thing. Merciful, Bladwin. Martha, Mr. Crescent has always been very good to you. So Mr. Crescent was always very good to him. There is another pass. Curiously enough, they do seems to able to meet each other eyes. So what happened? There is a pass. No one is speaking. Simply they are looking at their each eyes. They are seeing each other. Oh well, what are you going to do now, Robert? So Martha asked at the final what he is going to do. What do you mean? Bladwin asked, and Martha, you have been out of your work since the bank closed. So Martha is telling, after when the crime when they prove the crime, what happened, the bank will become they will close the bank, definitely you will get the job. Bladwin, oh, I will find the position means job. He will find, Bladwin said, definitely he will find the job. Martha, at your age, At this age are you going to get the job? Bladwin, it is the man that counts. The only it represents the character of the man, the work which they had, not by the age. It means the man that count. It means only by the man performance and the character and his behavior, they will give the job, not by the age. John, I heard from the doorman. Bladwin, what did you hear? John said he had heard something from the doorman, and Bladwin asked, what did you hear? John, it's he gone with the Third National Bank, you know, that Dorvan had got the job in the Third National Bank. Bladwin said, yes, he is helping with this reorganization, So the Third Bank is going to reorganize the bank which is lost by John Crescent. So what happened, that the Dorvan had joined there and he is working for the reorganizing. Yes, he is John. They won't take you on there. So John is telling they are not taken you there because the father had not got the job opportunity there. Bladwin, their staff was full. They wouldn't very well offered me a position as a clerk because there is a no vacancy because the staffs are full there. So he won't get any vacant there position. He won't get any job as a clerk there. John, that's why that was the what they told you. Mr. Marshall said he couldn't employ a man who have just as guilty as John Curzon. So that is the thing why the marshal had not employed you as a clerk, because you are as guilty as John Curzon. You have a hand, red hand with the John Curzon. That's why they are suspect you and they had not given the job there. Bladwin, but I'm not. Bladwin replied that he is not responsible for the crime which is did by John Curzon. John, who knows it? John said, no one knows the reality. Bladwin, everybody will tomorrow. Tomorrow, all will come to know what is the real thing that's happened. John, will they believe you or will they think you are trying to save your own skin? Whether they will believe, John is inquiring his father, whether the people will believe what you will say. And they won't believe you, he is telling. Bladwin, I found out only a day before the match. He knows only the day before when the bank is matched. It means it's going to destroyed or closed or collapsed. Who will believe that? John said, who is going to believe that? Bladwin, that I will have to. They will have to. Definitely they have to believe. John, how will you make them? I am afraid you will find them against you, whatever you go, Governor. You are testifying against John Curzon. Won't make things any better. If you were get another job, it will be with him. So he is telling, if you say anything wrong, what will happen? Definitely it will become against to his own life. You won't get a job if you ever get another job. So if he did anything, if he said anything wrong, definitely he won't get a job. So if Curzon doesn't go to jail, he will start the business again, won't he? And he can offer you anything less than his partner. So if John Curzon were not went to the jail, definitely he will start another own business and will make Bladwin as a partner. Bladwin, a partnership? John, with the 100,000 capital, you could put it in the business, Dad. So he is telling, if you get the bride money, because at the beginning I had told Eve and John, they were tempted of the huge amount. So they said, if he had not betray him, what happened? Definitely, John Curzon will give the bride amount, and by using that amount, he can start a business with Curzon also. So John look appealingly from one face to the another. They were awaited them. Awaited means oruthar kanna oruthar paaka mudiyama irukkudhu. If you say lie, we can't able to speak by seeing their eye. That it means you want me to take this money? Say yes or one of you or no. I wouldn't go into the partnership with Curzon. So he is telling whether you need Bladwin is arguing with the family whether they are asking him to get the bride money, and he is seeing one after another, say yes or no. He is not ready to go with the partnership of Mr. Curzon. So Martha, why not Bladwin? People could not trust him. People don't trust Curzon. John, then you could go into the business with someone else, Dad. 100,000 is lot of money. So if you are not, John had replied, if you are not ready to have a partnership with the Curzon, better you can start a business with someone else by getting the money of $100,000. Bladwin, God knows I never thought this day could come. I know no matter how you try to excuse it. I know that if you take this money, I do a dishonestable thing, and you know it. You and all of you come and admit me. So he is scolding the people of those who are in the house, Martha, for Eve and the daughter, and he is asking, you are asking me to become a dishonest man by getting the money. John, nobody will ever hear of it. No one will hear of it. Bladwin, but among ourselves, John, whatever you are, we are to the world, let us be honest with each other. The four of us, well, his glance travels from John to Eve, and whose head is bowed, from her wife to who apparently busy in his kidding. He raised Martha's head, look into her eye, and shouted, "Snatch, liars, hypocrites, thieves, and all I know better than any of you. We have seen our soul naked, and we shrunk to the Almighty heaven. Well, why don't you answer me?" So he is seeing each and every one, and he is rising the head of his wife, and he is seeing her eye, and he is asking, "Are you?" He is cursing them. They are scolding. All are the shame. liars. Hippocratics means they are acting as a good people. The Hippocratics, and no one is they are scolding that they have become bad, and God is seeing our soul naked. Means nammaloada aanmava kadavul paathirukkar. It means so we are doing, you all are started doing bad to the God. He is scolding everything, everybody. Martha, it's not wrong, Robert. It's not right. Martha said it is wrong, not wrong. But Gladwin replied, it's also not right one. John, 100,000 is a lot of money, Dad. Again and again, John is telling the 100,000 money is a very big, huge amount for them. Gladwin, you can look into your eye now. My son, can't you? So he is asking, you can look into my eye. You directly face my eye, but you can't. Because they are doing wrong. So John, Dad, why did you refuse? Isn't it because you were afraid of what we did say? So he is asking his father, are you thinking that we will say anything bad on you? But Gladwin, yes, John, he is telling, yes. Well, nobody will never know it. He is telling nobody knows the truth. Only we four will know the truth. Gladwin, except the four of us, yes, father. Then, abruptly they separate. Eve wipes in the silence. Martha, being less emotion, blow her nose noisily and fumbles with her kidding. John crawls out of the window, the Gladwin near the fireplace, clenches and unclenching his hands. Someone's coming. So what happened? All they got separated, and Eve went by crying, and Martha is busy in her work, and she is blowing her nose with noisily, and this boy John went to the window, and Gladwin, he went near the fireplace and he is sitting there. Someone coming. They had noticed that someone had come. For your better understanding, they had mentioned Gladwin feel ashamed of himself too. Mr. Marshall, the president of the Third National, another bank, come to his house to convey important news. Now Gladwin feel very ashamed of the thing which is happening in his house. And what happened at the time, Mr. Marshall is coming to their home to convey some important matter. Martha, who is it? John, I couldn't see. He looked like Mr. Marshall. So Martha is asking who is there coming, but John replied that he can't see who is coming, but at last he had find out it is Mr. Marshall. Gladwin, Mr. Marshall, the doorbell rings. He goes to the window commanding a view of the doorway. It's Mr. Marshall. So Gladwin went there and he find out that is a Mr. Marshall, and he said that is a Mr. Marshall is waiting there. Gladwin, it is Mr. Marshall. Martha, the president of the Third National. So he is the president of the Third National Bank. He had introduced, and Gladwin, yes, what does he want here? So Gladwin asked what he want here. Eve, shall I show him in, father? It means show him means katradile, allowing him to get inside the home. The Gladwin, yes, by all means. So he had come. Martha, Robert, be careful of what you say. You are to go to the stand tomorrow. So Martha is warning Robert that not to convey anything wrong. Whatever the thing he is going to speak, I should be careful. Gladwin, yes, I will look out. So he is telling, yes, he will know, he will manage. Marshall, coming into the room with a buoyantly, well, spending the afternoon indoor. How are you, Mr. Gladwin? And you, Gladwin? So he is asking he said that people are spending their day afternoon in the indoor, means they are spending at the home, and he is inquiring about Mrs. Gladwin as well as Gladwin both. Martha, we are just going out. Come, Eve. They are ready to go out. Just she is calling her Eve also with her. Oh, you needn't go on to my account. Because of his presence, we don't need to go. You can hear what I have say. So you have to. You also hear what he is going to say. Gladwin, if you feel like coming around to the Third Bank National, sometimes in this week you will find the position waiting for you. So he said, if you find time to come near to the Third Bank, really there is a position, there is a job for you. The job is waiting for you, he said. Gladwin, do you mean that Mr. Marshall is not able to believe? And thunderstruck means without this belief, he is asking whether it's real. Marshall, I don't say if it's meant. I was in to see Crescent this afternoon. He told me about the offer he had made you, but he know that no amount of the money could make you to do something you thought wrong. Gladwin, he paid you the supreme compliment rather than go to the trial with you to testify against him. He confessed. So what happened? The marshal had said yesterday he went to meet Crescent. Crescent had said that Gladwin will the amount which he is going to offer for the Crescent. Robert is not ready to get the money. Even he is not going to make Robert to under a difficult situation. So he himself, Crescent himself, is going to accept. That is a confesses. It means he is going to accept the crime which is done by himself. So Gladwin confessed. He is going to accept. It means Marshall told the whole story. I can only say to you, whatever man will saying to be saying tomorrow, how highly I honored and respect your husband, how sincerely. So now Marshall is telling the pride of the Robert Gladwin to his wife, how sincere, how honest, how respect he was. He had Mr. Marshall had on it, and how he was sincerely, how he was truthful. He was very much respected by his truth. Masha, please, can't you see he's crying? Slowly the curtain fall. What happened? She's Martha. Robert is started to shed his tears because he was get the reward for his truthness. That's why they had given the title Honor of the Heart of the Truth, because of his truthness he got rewarded. So whatever the thing we are doing in our life, we should not wait for the compliment. We have to do the best what we can able to do. So go through the story and write the summary of the story, supplementary lesson, the heart of the truth. Thank you.